Hello, everybody. Welcome to Trinity House. My name is Pete Werdock. If you can read my lanyard, for whatever went wrong, I'm sorry. I did my best, okay? And this is a cool thing about tonight is like, you guys had a chance to either come and see Stu, this tribute to Stu, or spend $5,000 and take your kids to Taylor Swift, right? So this is a much better deal, don't you think? I think so. Bill Keith, he is the man of the hour. Over the last several months, you know, I talked to a lot of people through Facebook about Stewart. By the way, feel free to join me on Facebook if you ever like to talk politics. I'm sure we can change the world. But Bill and I got to talking, and Stewart obviously has played here many times, as have a lot of these amazing musicians. And yada, 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 here we are. I almost, you know, when I started this, it was, yeah, I live in the Upper Peninsula, and so I was kind of doing a lot of this from afar. But I got Mr. Pete Peltier as the music director. He's not playing on this tune, he's playing on another. And Bill Harvey, I called him the cat herder that helped kind of get the rehearsals together and things, which was great. But
Billy.
Yeah. So, yeah, I live in the Upper Peninsula. I used to live in Royal Oak, and that's how Stu and I met a long time ago. But it was really funny because yesterday I was walking my dog. I have a greyhound, most beautiful dog on the planet. We were walking downtown Royal Oak looking at all the changes, and we're in front of Mr. B's. And, you know, there's nobody there, and a waitress comes out, and she says, "Hey, can I get you something to drink?" And I said, "Yeah, I'll take a beer." And she looks down at my dog, Petey. I'm not a narcissist. That's really his name. Honestly. And she says, "What'll he have?" And he looks up at her, and he says, "I have an ice water with a lemon." And then she looks back at him, and she says, "Wow, you're a talking dog. You should join the circus." And then he looks at her deadpan and says, "What, they're hiring electricians at the circus?" So there we go. Needed that one. All right, I'm going to turn it over to a professional now. The golden voice who's been around Detroit for 40 years in broadcasting. She started when she was 5. And it's Ann DeLisi who has, you know her by the smile in her voice when she speaks. And she is, here she is. Here she is. So, yes. The mic to take out is right down here.
When I want to?
When you want to? Yeah.
Okay.
And, just a couple of housekeeping things.
Oh, I thought it was coming out.
No, you're coming out.
I thought that was my introduction.
It was. There's some CDs available if you want some out there. There's a program that has some information about all these incredible musicians. If you didn't get one, grab one at the counter there, because this show would not have happened without them. And we are glad you're here. Now I'm turning it over to the professional.
Okay.
How are you guys? Boy, this is so great. You know, there's a bunch of people in this room I haven't seen in a long time. And it's really great to see everybody and everybody gathering for one of the best people I ever met. So, Stewart and I used to have breakfast all the time. We would discuss his music, everybody's music, talk about tennis, all the good stuff. And I just love you, Stu. You are the best of us.
You are
the best of us. And Stewart is the only person that could get away with calling me DeLucy, which he has done for a long time. He's on the short list of one that could get away with that.
DeLucy!
There it is. He he would say, you got some splaining to do. That's what that was. There are the musicians you're going to hear tonight are just the speaking of the best of us, they are. And to have them all gathered together to celebrate the incredible music that Stewart has created, it's just going to be a real joy for all of us. So I'm really honored to be here, and thank you all for coming out tonight. I think you're just going to have the best time. So we're going to get started. So we're going to go through Stewart's songs, and there's tons of them, so we're going to get to some of them tonight. And it's going to be great to hear all these great musicians performing them for you. So let's get started. The song is King of the Summer Hotel, performed by Bob Barrera and John Henry. Harvey, John Harvey. Jeez. I'm
all right,
sorry.
And you're fired.
That's kind of my entire musical career right there.
Go, John Henry.
If you don't like it, it's John Henry. If you like it, it's John Harvey.
Let the games begin. Stewart.
Hey, Robert.
Julia, nice to see you. Stewart, in your tribute, Johnny and I are going to be the first ones. So we got the baby on drums. Come on. Back in, this goes out to the days of drinking at Laser Tours and walking to the Metro Music Cafe, where Stu and I would turn the sign that said the king on and off. Watch the wild child dance in the foxfire while the wind rings down with the trucks heading south on 13. Shiny cold and hot, a buzzing highway.
having
me. Thank you.
Love you, Stu.
Such a good song. It's called Breaking Under It All. Please welcome Rob Dewar. With him about this next song. He loved it. and he loved Stew, and we played it like crazy because it was such a great song. So I'm so excited to hear it tonight, performed by C.D. Henderson, Kiss Kiss Bang Bang.
Do it justice. Love you, bro.
Yeah.
And she said, so the world won't last. These things are moving far too fast. So sure, it's not true. Every time it rains, she tells her friends, every day is the same.
Bang! Bang!
absolutely perfect, as is this next one. Oh, so glad we're going to do this. So this next one's going to be performed by Anthony Harrell and Tracy Lee Bouchard. It's called Skin to Skin. This duet is so good. Put your hands together for these guys.
Hello.
Time, river sound. The moment you're around,
I always feel your touch. Love you so much. Fire kisses our soul.
Take this love from the shadows. Oh, skin to skin is where we begin tonight. Darling, skin to skin is where we begin tonight, baby.
I'm in New Orleans now, in the evening air. Night is calling out a quiet lover's prayer.
Like a strum, a dream,
of an old sweet song. Oh, skin to skin is where we begin tonight. Darling, skin to skin is where we begin tonight. Baby,
there are 3 degrees to love.
Two is kind,
and the third I've learned concerns the fire between us.
Between us,
I hear the wind and rain against our pain, but it's warm.
This is Obi-Wan Kenobi for me, Mr. C.D. Henderson. He came to make sure I wasn't mucking up too bad.
Let me get out of your way, C.D. Yes, I know, but anyway. Okay.
Now I get to do my favorite song by this beautiful man.
Soul is ready, you know.
Ba 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 ba.
And the world is on fire tonight.
Summer on the river, shoot the moon
right out of the sky for you.
Listen to the band.
The world is rushing by. The
CD.
Oh, hi, Ann.
How's it going?
I don't see you to be my boss.
I used to. Sort of.
Yeah.
We worked together. It was a great time.
It was a good time.
So I wanted to mention the horn players. Jim Wilpula on sax, how about that? And Dave Shelby on trumpet. Aren't those guys great? And another hand for Anthony Harrell, how about that? And Tracy Lee Bouchard taking care of all these backing vocals. She sounds so great. And you're no slouch there, CD. All right, we're going to continue right now. We're bringing Jeff Scott out to perform Heart of a Heartless World.
Mr. Francke, Mrs. Francke.
Hi.
Hanging in there. I'm having fun. And I love listening to your music, that is for sure.
Thank you.
This world, it's so fast and cold and hard. I don't hear music that I love. Come across the yard. I've been up, I've been down, from the sky to the ground, looking for a heart of a heartless world. Heart of a heartless world. Come from this car town, weaving up and weaving down. It's getting hard to stick around, in for a penny or a pound. I've been up, I've been down, from the sky to the ground, looking for a heart of a heartless world. Heart of a heartless world. Looking for a heart of a heart, heart of a heart, heart of a heartless world. Look from here to Blacksburg, Virginia, Mississippi, clear to Denver. This world, she ain't there. Love is very, very rare. Hear the something going on over there. Hey, hey. I said farewell to my mama. I said goodbye to my dad. Is we really on our own now? I'm gonna do the best I can. I've been high, I've been down, from the sky to the ground, looking for a heart of a heartless world. World. Looking for a heart of a heartless world. Looking for a heart of a heartless world. Heart of a heartless world.
Switching to Lucy. And I'm not talking about my shirt.
That can only come from one person and get away with it. Make me laugh. How you doing out there, Stu?
Doing good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You having fun? Everybody having fun? This is so great. Okay, this next artist is a part of the history of Detroit's culture, music, words, poetry, and I'm so happy that he's here tonight. Please welcome M.L. Liebler performing Between the Ground and God.
Hello, everybody. Yeah, I told Pete I need a,
thank you.
I told Pete I needed a music stand because I don't even know my own poems, let alone Stewart's poems, of which this is a great one. I'll just mention this real quick. In 1995, I read a review, and Stu knows this, I read a review of his first album. I didn't hear it, and I immediately thought, this is perfect. It's a great album. And I sent him a fax, that's how long. At the Metro Times, and I said, brother, I know this album is great, I'm gonna go buy it now, but even I don't have to listen to it, I know it's great. And of course it was, and it is. That's true, that's a true story. Okay, so this is a poem of Stewart's called Between the Ground and God, and I'll try to give it my best shot. Talk of how you've been around. If you're the queen, darling, where's your crown? They call your name just outside of town. Then you lay down with that bitter crowd. There is a place where I and the streets are cold. Those party boys know you're far too old. But the lights still flash, the camera rolls, and all that glitter is seldom gold. There is a place where I come from. Faith in what we've done. Now won't you live between the ground and God? I want to live between the ground and God. The lights go out.
what we've done. I want to live between the ground and God. I want to live between the ground and God.
Thank you. Thank you.
You guys take a break. Any questions so far? No? All
right. Where's the other drummer?
Ouch.
How'd you get on the guest list?
How do you know when the drum riser is perfectly level? There's drool coming out of both corners of his mouth.
Okay, everybody. Moving on. Okay, this beautiful voice that you've heard on all singing all night, she's finally going to take the main microphone. Tracy Lee Bouchard is going to perform Big Red. Thank you. Y'all ready?
Yeah, ready, all right. Stu, you are an amazing person and an amazing writer and an amazing friend. I just gotta say, years ago, when I met Stuart, I was introduced to him by another good friend of mine that he wanted to help me get back into original music because I was a jukebox for so long in top 40 bands, and he suggested that I talk to Stu. And, you know, he was already a big star at the time. He did not need to have anything to do with me, but he gave me some great advice, and he mentored, you know, brought me along and told me, you know, what to do, what not to do, basically, and asked me, was gracious enough to ask me to sing with him. And I met so many cool people through you, Stu. And you are just, there aren't any words that are adequate to say how everybody feels about you, and you've just heard out.
Yeah.
And this is a great song. Y'all sing along, baby.
She employs immutable laws of nature. She keeps her dreams beneath her bed. She writes ransom notes on Dixie cups. She will stay inside your head. Give the girl what she wants. Give the girl what she needs. Give the girl what she wants. Give the girl what she needs. Pull her down to your she's bound to blossom, so I gather her petals at my feet. I take her dancing after hours till the barmaid rolls out the street. Give the girl what she wants. Give the girl what she needs. Give the girl what she wants. Give the girl what she needs. Pull her down. to your big bed, down to your big bed, down to your big bed, down to your big
bed. Dave Feeney, you know.
I'm very much in the way. All right, Tracy Lee Bouchard, so great. So wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. Everybody sounds great. So you've been hearing Bob Mervak back there sounding fabulous on the keys tonight. And he's going to do a song for us now. Are you coming up here or are you staying back there?
I'm going to stay back here.
You have extra responsibilities, I understand. Okay, you can stay back there.
On my guitar.
Please put your hands together for Bob Mervak. He's going to perform Summer Soldier.
I'm going to scale this down, just the piano and guitar, kind of bring it down a little bit.
Bring it down.
It's an honor to even touch this song that Stewart wrote and that the boss touched too, right? Bruce Springsteen. And here he is. No, just kidding.
You know what I remember about this song, Stu, was playing this song in Toledo and Cleveland when we opened for Bob Seger, playing this song on a big stage like that. It was amazing. It was just incredible.
I remember that, too. Check, check, check. John, could I just get, like, can you dial me a little more high, maybe dial a little bit of that mid out and give me a little more level, just a tiny little bit. Thank you so much, sir.
Sleep for promises we've never
that train arrives, and I can hear my title clear. We'll walk together. Yeah, brother, we'll walk on out of here. And we'll understand it all in the by and by. Holla, holla, holla if you're hearing me. Holla,
holla,
holla if you're hearing me. Holla,
holla, holla,
holla if you're hearing me.
Playing guitar on this, I am.
So this next artist, I've been a fan of hers for a long, long time, and I was not surprised one bit that she's on the bill tonight to honor Stewart. What, can I help you? What's happening
That's
here?
Virginia.
Oh, I would you like, would you want this one?
I can stay here. Go ahead.
Well, then what's gonna happen? Are you look like you're gonna talk? Are you gonna sing or talk?
I was just gonna say a little something. Just since we're here and we're talking about the history of Stu's music, and I figured I'd give you a little kind of where it all began. Just the reason why we're all up here is because of one person. The reason why you're all here is because of one person. But when it all began is when Stu always played guitar, got me to start to play guitar. I just wanted to learn Blackbird. And then I bought his guitar. And he moved to back from California, and he took a class at LCC, and he came back and he said, hey, this is a performers band class and there's no drummer. And he goes, you play drums? And I go, yeah, when I was 6 or 5, you know? And he goes, no, just come show up. And we just started, we went to this class and we played like, I don't know, what did we play, Stu? 3 songs, A Day in the Life, you know, just 3 songs, and we went through it and we go, well, that was kind of fun. And so this kid that was in the class, I bought his drums from him, and we went to the All Gray Hotel, and that summer we played every weekend. Right, Sue? It was every Saturday at the Point All Gray Hotel. And it went in, and the next thing we know, they moved to Detroit. Stu graduated from college. I didn't, so I needed a job, so let's go to Detroit and play some music. And so the Point began, and I want to point out one thing. We have 3 girls, and Lindsay is one of them here today. Lindsay, stand up. This is one of the original From the Point from the 80s, fans of Stu's. It's still showing up. And it's just amazing how these, you know, the dedicated fans that we have here, that, you know, they just stay. And Troy, where are you? Troy used to come out to all the shows, moved to Philly. He flew here tonight, you know? I mean, these are devoted fans. You know, and so when after the Point and we get together and we have, Stu just wants to keep writing, and his writing just takes off, and he finds, you know, Chip, I think was the first one. I think Chip was, I don't know, Chip, you were making chopsticks at a wallet factory or something, you know, so, you know, he had this talent, but he brought all this together and we just morphed into more people playing, and it's just one amazing thing that Stu's music kept on climbing. It was almost hard to keep up with in a way. And so, Stu, of course, you know how much I love you. And it's truly an honor to bring all these people together, this incestuous family, how we all play within each other and we play about forever. And this is something that I think is very special for all of us. And Pete tonight said, we should just do this again. You know? Let's just do this again, you know? So stay tuned, and hopefully we'll, you know, do this again later on in the year, or, you know, more people. Maybe we'll take it on the road. We might get discovered. Thank you for listening. Stu, I love you.
Good egg. All right, I'm so glad you guys are here tonight. You're having fun. This is pretty great, right? Yeah. All right. All right. This next artist, you all know her. You've all seen her. She's such a talent and such a force. She's been making music for a long time. And I'm not surprised one bit that she wanted to sing tonight. Please put your hands together for Jill Jack.
Hi. Hi, Stu. Stu doesn't, you know, I don't know. Stu and I used to call each other Donnie and Marie because we had all these teeth. So we did shows together. They had to make a poster big enough for our teeth. Since Billy talked 20 minutes before I got up here, I was nervous. I'm like, shut up, baby. Let's get going. Isn't this a incredible night? Right?
We've been west, and Lily's barefoot, walking across the bedroom floor. For 30 years and all she's counted on, fall like dust on a sacred climb. She takes the power in from her hair, drapes her dress across the chair. She'll act her age, be daddy's girl, one last time. With the windows wide, she hears a lonely cry. She puts on pads and kind of starts to cry. The things she ponders while the record's there. Live a life mother recognized. She feels a warm air on her skin. Holds her shoulder so cold there. Without a sound, where'd it begin? How it goes. She can ride the highway cold in the pitch black air. She can dance all night at the gypsy fair. She can change her clothes. She can change her hair. On the summer wind, sees the time to begin again. Take the car keys from the hook, waste the time with one last look. Turn the wheel towards Hammond Beach, and this is how it goes. She can ride Hollis Road in a pitch black air. She can dance all night at the gypsy fair. She can change her clothes. She can change her hair. Love won't make her say. She can ride Hollis Road in a pitch black air. She can dance all night at the gypsy fair. She can change her clothes. She can change her hair. Love won't make her say.
I know we all shouldn't talk too much, but Stu's in, he's been in my life for a really long time, and he's always been there for me. And even last year, he called me when I was sick, and I thought it was Julia, and I started bawling when I heard his voice. But he was there, that standing in the parking lot when I found out I had breast cancer in 2005. He was just standing there, and he grabbed my shoulders and he said, "Live, live, live." And he was there for me when my dad died. He called me every day, gave me a great therapist name to get through the grief. And when I was sick with COVID, he's just, and this is just my story. There's millions and millions and millions of stories of the people that, Stuart, that you've helped in your lifetime. And you're an angel on this earth. And you've always been a role model to me. And I just love you very much. We set our hearts on rock and roll when we were boys, then banished ourselves from their world. We placed ourselves in all their beautiful noise and swore we'd stay close to the bone. Those summer nights, they yelled till they heard brown eyed girls. Now all those lovely joints have burned to down to the ground. Close your eyes, you can still hear the sound. We made sense of the world with two guitars, bass and drums.
Jill, I'm shrinking in my old age here, man. This is just about right for me.
Hey, Logie. How you doing?
Good, you?
need a microphone, don't you? You want that one? All right. All right. Boy, is it something we said? They all left. Everybody's leaving. All right. John has been making music in Detroit how long?
40 years.
He's been making some incredible, writing some incredible songs and performing for 40 years. And it's so, just such an honor to have you here tonight, John. So please welcome John D. Lamb, who's going to perform Peace Like a River. Thanks for being here.
Thanks, Stuart, for being a little bit more history. So, Johnny Lamb, Stu and I started when we did the point. John
was playing at Marcel's. Anybody remember Marcel's? Yeah. At 10 and Woodward, where our first gigs were, and John was just starting. He'd come up and sing Prove It All Night. Remember that, Stu? Yeah. Every night you get up and sing Prove It All Night. I have a couple of tapes from recordings, but we played the same circuit for ever. John's a good friend, goes way, way back.
It's going too fast. Still no questions?
Okay. We're having a conference back there. Microphone mount. I'm just gonna stay here. Okay. So that fine man dressed in that fine red blazer and shoes to match, Jim Hebler from the Civilians, has a presentation to make before he performs. He's going to come up and say a few words.
Check, check. Check, check. Check, check. What's great about Stu Francke is he's a writer, and he engages everything from a writer's eye. He has a song, and I'm a primary song writer, lyricist in a band that he helped break called the Civilians, and we would all talk. He worked gloaming into a song, and it's tasteful and well done. Anyway, if you knew Stu before Facebook and social media and everyone thinking they had the chops to be a journalist or a music writer or a scribe and knew what the hell they were talking about, Stu worked on columns. He wrote in publications, he had a band we all wanted to emulate, right? And because of that, organically, we came up with a great name. He's Stu Senior's only son, right? And he used to resist Frank Sinatra, right? And then he embraced Frank Sinatra, and you gotta love Sinatra, right? He's one of the all-time greats, right, with the Beatles. So organically, the baby's organically, I think he's on drums behind me, we called Stu the chairman. And it fits. So I told Stu, we had a long conversation before he got punched in the head a couple weeks before, and we were gonna get back, and it was a 90-minute conversation, and Stu mentored our band. He wrote about our band. I think the writing, he called me an enigma. I had to look it up in the dictionary. Is that good? He compared the great C.D. Henderson to John Entwistle, and he said in the midst of impending crack up, there's a bunch of great songs in there. And that's how I met Stu. I have to go meet that guy. That's really well said, and I gotta meet him. So I want everyone to give a big round of applause. We're gonna, everyone here has agreed that we're gonna present this. Stu's not a hat guy, but we're gonna, Julia and Stu are gonna put this on the mantle, and we're gonna have photos that everyone's gonna sign. And this is to the chairman. This is your fedora. And Stu, I'm wearing my fedora for you today. Last thing, everyone knew I'd be a little windy, I'm beating the baby at being windy. We did a gig, no, but Stu was so cool at educating me. He called me his little brother and all this shit, and that was an honor, right? And I didn't know a lot about Van Morrison, and we opened up for him at the Magic Bag to a packed house, and he got an encore, and he's doing this Van Morrison song, and I was so naive about Van Morrison, I called Stu Monday. That's tune you closed with could be a major effing hit for you. Stu goes, it's Van Morrison, Jim. So he taught me about Van Morrison. All right, this is called Into the Mystic. Let's do it. Mm-hmm. we were born before the wind. Also younger than the sun. Here the barnacle was one. We sail into the mystic. Hark now, baby, the sailors cry. Smell the sea and that point lookout sky. Let your soul go up and fly into the mystic. That home now blues. I'll be coming home. Hey, Sherman, my shoes match. I got a fedora on. I got a sport coat on. I'm ready for the cruise ships, brother. Take care. Love you, brother. Love you too, Julia and Kit and everyone in this room. God bless you.
I remember hearing Stu perform that song so many times, didn't you? Hear Stuart perform that so beautifully. I never got old listening to him perform that. All right, we're gonna continue. We've got just a few more songs here. We're like moving through the night at a pretty good clip, I gotta say. So, Jay, all right. Everybody looking ready? Everybody looking ready? We look ready. I think we're ready. All right. Again, thank you so much for coming. Thank you all for being here. We're going to continue. Oh, this is such a great song. It's called Sidewalk Dimes. And I haven't heard this one in so long, so it's going to be lovely to hear Graham Strachan perform it tonight. Please put your hands together.
Yes, this is your...
Bass drum back here. That's her. How old is she? How old were you, Tess?
Like, I took Julia's camera, and it's one of those beautiful summer
photo.
Nights at the cottage. In I think she was like 7, 8 years old, maybe. What's Julia? Is that
summer? It's the sweetest photo.
All she was doing was spinning all night long. That's all she was doing. Spinning. Now she's a nurse.
Listen, I get sick, that's why I'm not taking care of me. So you've heard me teasing Bill all night, because that's what we've always done. But in all seriousness, he could not have been a more loyal friend to Stu. Best friends in everything, thick as thieves in every way. He's incredibly talented and incredibly kind with a big fat heart. That's why we love him so much.
Thank you, Ann. I'm going to say,
how about this? Bill's going to sing. How do drummers sing and play? It just like blows my mind. All right, there it is. All right, so Bill's going to sing for us now. He's
going to
sing Light of the World.
The song off of Stu's first record, which is special to me. He did this originally off of the Beautiful Go Blameless cassette, the two cassette series that he did. I always loved this song. It's just one of my favorite songs of days of yore, called Light of the World. Shout out all the things we're not.
Yes, Stu. Thanks, brother.
As I said at rehearsal on Thursday, I'm glad I inspired you to write all these great songs.
Me too.
All right, we're going to bring Jeff Scott back out. That's a good idea, right? Putting Jeff to work a lot here tonight. It's okay, right? All right, so we're going to have Jeff out again, and he's going to, oh, this is such a great song. So, this is another one I haven't listened to in a while, Stu, and I know Jeff is going to make it quite lovely to hear. This is a song called Expecting Heroes. Put your hands together once again for Jeff Scott.
Would you mind if I took a minute and a half to say something? Okay. So, I'm going to say three things. So, in a land far, far away a long time ago, I started work out of college at an ad agency, and there was this gorgeous young woman, blonde, who worked there, and her name was Julia. So, of course, you know, I had intentions, you know. And then I found out, you know, her boyfriend was a tennis pro, and he was a writer, and I have no chance of that. So, we became friends. About 4 years later, a radio station in town released my first single ever, which was really nice. And this guy calls me on the phone, and he wants to interview me because he's working for the Metro Times. And it's Stewart Francke. Like, I don't know if you guys were married at that point. He's like, I know Julia. It's nice. And he grilled me. I thought, okay, this is great training, because he was grilling me during this interview. So that was nice. So flash forward many, many years, and I ended up leaving music for about 17 years. And when I got back into doing it, one of the first guys I called was Stewart. Didn't really know him that well, but we became, and he said, yeah, of course, man, I'll meet you at the diner at Lincoln and Woodward. That was a good thing. Right?
Stu's office.
Yeah. And he brought me this wealth of information and promotional stuff, and I just couldn't have asked for any better sort of tutelage and guidance and mentorship, you know. And that continued for all of these years. And if I had a song I was working on and I wanted an objective opinion, I would send it to Stu, and he would tell me what he thought, and good or bad. I just want to take this opportunity to tell you I love you. I want to thank you for everything you've done for me. And
love you too, man. My pleasure.
You are a hero to me, my brother. Born in 1958, we were the world's souls. I heard you, Frank Sinatra, said you'd fly me to the moon. A strange time in my life. Yeah, can we shine? Love this world, ring of spells, secrets just won't tell. Through the wild, cut my rope, all my restlessness goes slow. Oceans go, oceans go.
Expecting heroes. sister waiting for him out on Washburn Park. Turns the corner, brand new Chevrolet, painted with color.
Before we go to the next song, can we bring the house lights up a little bit?
because Stu has a few things he wants to say. And so, CD, can you get that microphone over there? Bring it. Thank you so much.
This one?
Yeah.
That's the one. So we're going to just get that over to Stu. I might have to go, like, over.
See, here.
Yeah. Oh, perfect. Thanks, everybody.
All right, everybody. Thank you so much for coming tonight. I'm totally honored and just blown away by the talent. Thank you for doing my song so well, giving them justice. I want to thank Pete Wurdock for putting this together. Yeah. He's the heart and soul of this thing, and it was his idea, and he put it together, and all you guys replied, I'm just blown away. I want to thank Bill Keith here at the Trinity House.
Yeah. Yeah.
I want to thank the great Ann DeLisi for being the MC. Thank you so much. Yeah. Love you. I want to thank Bill Harvey for all his wit and fun and drumming. I want to thank my friend Rob Dewar, too, who helped put this together.
Yeah.
And I want to thank all the musicians who are here tonight, just blown away by your talent and your dedication to my songs. So thank you very much. I just got a couple more thank yous. I want to thank my wife, Julia. My kids, Tess and Stewie, wherever they are. Right behind me. And Malachi, too. Yes. Okay, and I just got a couple more thank yous.
Sure.
Really, that's it. Everyone who came tonight, thank you so much. It's a beautiful evening. Thank you. I'm totally honored.
Come on.
Incredible musicians. Boy, I know there's a Taylor Swift concert going on tonight, but there is doesn't compare to the love in this room, no way. This is the absolute perfect place to be. And this will set you on a great path with all kinds of love and happiness in your heart for everything that we did tonight. We love you so much, Stu. This is one final song. Thanks again to all these great musicians who came out on the Saturday night. They did rehearsals and everything just to make it perfect, and it has been a perfect night. So one more song. This is House of Lights.
This is a song I wish I would have wrote. This is the one that had gloaming in it. And I come from an era where we had two primary lyric writers, and me and Dave Gallons. He worked gloaming into a song. How did he do it? So you'll hear it. Go ahead, everyone.
Thank you.
I watch my children student chess playing. I'll be my luckiest child. Good is my fortune. The hand that feeds me has lost all its power.